All right, here we go for area number 2 of the Luigi's Mansion walkthrough. Very beautiful. Now, as you remember in the last part, we got the key to area 2, which should open up this door here. It's doing its nonsense. All right, so we're cleared to get in. Now, I remember when I first got to area 2, when I was playing the game, and I was a bit overwhelmed by how big it actually was compared to Area 1. And, I mean, it really is rather large. And it took me forever to figure out what to do first. But what you want to do is you want to go down this hall all the way to the end here. And you go to the last door on the left. I didn't mean to go to that one. Last door on the left. And it should bring you to a bathroom, I believe. Alright, so here you encounter the choky ghosts, as I call them, because they come up from behind you and choke you. So you deal with those. Professor Egad calls you and said, "Looks like you need more training, son." But you don't really actually need more training, because you don't. So you get the key that appears on that shelf up there. You get it, and it should grant you access to the, I think they call it the ballroom, the dance hall. But, you know, we'll see. Top left corner, if you remember. Alright, so here we are at the next room, in case you didn't catch where it was. You can always check on the Game Boy Horror. Alright, so here we are. We get to see if it's the dance hall or the ballroom. It's the ballroom. And you get these ghosts that are indicative of Shy Guys. Now, what you want to do with these guys is you can't just shine your flashlight on them. You got to suck their masks off with the vacuum cleaner. So you get their masks off, you zap them. We don't really zap them. You use the flashlight, and you get them. All right. So you don't really need to see me catch all of them, so let's skip through that. Okay, so we got the last guy. After you clear out all the Shy Guys, they appear back there, those two ghosts. There. Now, there's a secret to getting them to appear out of the shiny stuff, and I believe what it is you gotta stay on the spinny stuff and look up. I don't know, but I haven't really truly figured it out, but maybe you can if you try hard enough. So, working away at the health there, and they're gone. Gonna get some of the pearls laying around, because that's good. Alright, pearls. Okay. Checking the lighting fixtures. Getting the key. The key is to the door right there that you say over there to the right. And I believe that room, I actually have no idea what the name of for this room is. But that aside, when you come in, there's a blue ghost right over there in the corner. I think it's either in the box or the chair. You see, I kind of struggled with that a bit, but I got him. I got him. Yes. I'm amazing. Trust me, it feels good when you catch those blue ghosts. And you can see I got this obnoxious pink thing following me. I'll deal with that. But I'd like to point out this specific red choky ghost here. The red ones have a special quality that when they choke you, they actually take away your health. I mean, you'd think that they would all do that, but I think only the red ones and the blue ones and the pink ones, choky ghosts, do that. Yes. I don't, you might see an example sooner or later, but yeah, as you can see, I'm kind of working away at these guys. Oh, fail! Fail. That was a fail. I'm sorry. Okay, we got the lights on, and I'd like you to look right in the mirror. That right there, if you can see it in the terrible quality, it is a button. Now we're gonna go up, we're gonna hit the button, which will then activate this cutscene. The wall is moving back. Yes. And here we go. Now this is going to bring out a very important element in the game. So you better be watching closely. Yeah, unless you already know what's happening. Alright, so we pull this poster off the wall. Another button. Yeah, and we all love buttons. It opens up the hatch in the floor, and then all the booze inside the hatch in the floor escape. Well, I wouldn't really call it escaping. I don't know why they... Okay, yeah, they're escaping. And here you go. You got this guy. This is the big douchebag with the jewel on his head. He escapes as well. And then Luigi, he's done having his heart attack. And now Professor Egad calls and he's all like, "You fool! Why did you do that?" But he doesn't actually say that because this is a... And they also don't use words like douchebags. Anyways, he's going to bring you back to the lab and he's going to explain a new function to your Game Boy Horror, but we're just going to let you do that. Okay, so pertaining that you actually read what Egad said about the boo detector on the Game Boy Horror, you should notice the blue light. And of course, now that you're in a room with the lights on, it's flashing. Yellow means that there's a boo in the room, basically, and red means that you're right next to the object that the boo is hiding in. Now, you want to go to the object and hit it, and the boo will come out like so. Now, you can't lock onto the boos, so, I mean, in a sense, you kind of do lock onto them, but it's not, like, stunning the regular ghosts. So... You know, I'm just going through right now, going through all the rooms that I have already lit up and capturing the boos, which is a good idea to do, a good idea, because you want to go back and you want to cover everything before you move on. You know, finish what you started. So, once again, I'm going through all the rooms that we already completed, and I'm going to go get the boos there. All right. Okay, so I went back and I got all the boos in the lights rooms. I think my number was off because I forgot to go into a specific room, but don't worry about that. If you just do what I told you, everything's going to be fine. So now we're heading back to the bathroom door that we couldn't get into before, down at the end of the hallway. You see, you got your toad in here, and, I don't know what I'm doing right now. Oh, okay, I'm just getting the coins in the light. Alright, so I'm going to go up and talk to the toad. He's going to be all like, "I flushed something down the toilet." No, because he flushed something down the toilet, and go figure, it was a key. So, you tell him everything's gonna be okay, blah, 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 blah. Here we go, talking. I'm the one doing the talking. Alright, so you open the toilet, and you got the key. Now, the key is to the fortune teller's room, which should be at the front of the hallway. I don't know what I'm doing. What am I doing? I'm scanning the toilet. Okay. Alright then, to the fortune teller's room. Alright, so I'm walking down the hallway to the fortune teller's room. Justin, do you not hear me saying things? Oh my god. Okay, so we're gonna rewind it to before Justin started making a whole bunch of noise. Okay, right there. Alright, so now we're going back down to the hallway to the fortune teller's room, and there's gonna be this gold mouse that comes out of the wall right there! See it? Dude, it's crazy! That happens about 25% of the time when you play the game, the gold mouse comes out. And it's down this hallway right before you go into the fortune teller's room for the first time. Okay. So now we're going in the room for real. Alright. You got your standard setup. I accidentally walked back outside because I was trying to open that drawer over there, but I was too close to the door. Alright, you got yourself a gold bar. Going over here, you got yourself a nothing. Okay, now there's also a block of cheese behind the fortune teller's bench. You want to scan the block of cheese. And the mouse comes out, another golden mouse. You get some more money. We all love the money, don't we? I love collecting the money. I already said that. Love collecting stuff in this game. Alright. Now the real reason we're in here is to go into the room that is connected to the fortune teller's room. Alright. Door locked behind you. Now, this is a special room because it's the mirror room, but there are ghosts that spawn in here that you can only see in the mirrors. So, you've got to, I don't know, you don't really need to be that smart to be able to do this, but you got to be smart enough to realize that you got to look in the mirror, opposite directions, reverse, blah. Yeah. Alright. So, I'm going to suck up these ghosts. Let's skip to the end where we get all of them. Alright, so the room is lit up now, and we got this nice big chest. Now, don't look for the boo yet. Go into the chest, I'm telling you. And inside, you got yourself, I believe it is called the Fire the Medallion. Now, Egad's gonna call you, he's gonna explain to you what it was. Basically, there are three element medallions you get in the game. There is fire, water, and ice. As you can see right here, you first got the fire one. Now, this lets you expel those specific elements out of the Poltergust 3000. So, to get out of the room, we're going to suck up this thing that comes out of the fire like that. And we're going to light the candles in the room. In case you're not familiar with how to light the candles, you use the L button to expel the stuff. So, alright, so here we go. Looking for the boo. He's probably over here. And now he's not over there. Okay, here he is. Okay, you probably realize by now that, yeah, every time you capture a boo, Professor Egad asks you if you want to save, and you save. Okay, so now we're leaving the mirror room, and now what you want to do here is you want to once again light all the candles. After you're done lighting all the candles, a key should drop on one of the pillars up here. Yes, right there. This key, I believe, is to the washing room, yes. Now we're heading down to the washing room, I believe it was called. We'll clear up that issue right now. The laundry room. Okay, laundry room. Alright, you got your standard ghosts going on in here. Nothing too special, just some pink ghosts, choky ghosts. So we're going to skip to the end where this room is lit up. Alright, room is lit up. You got yourself a nice chest over there. Now I want you to go over to the washing machine, open it up, and you got yourself some very nice Mario's hat. Alright, that's an important key element in the game, and I will explain what to do with that later. Right now I'm looking for the boo. Once again, you really don't need to see that, so we're going to skip to opening the chest and seeing the beautifulness. That is quite beautiful, if I do say so myself. Very beautiful. Okay, so we're done in here. Now we're going to go into the butler's room. Now, this plays a very important role in three cases, I suppose. One, in the bucket over here in the corner, there is a sapphire jewel stone thing. And number two, you may realize that there are mice running around in this room. That's important. So first I'm going to go over to this cabinet and get the money, but there are mice in here, which means that there is a mouse hole in this room. So you're going to go over to this part of the room, scan the mouse hole in the wall, you go inside it, and you should have yourself some secret room, the hidden room. Okay, now, yeah, the bats assault you from the ceiling. Now, there are special ghosts in here, and I believe I can call them element ghosts, right there. These ghosts have the ice element inside them, which means that you need the fire element in order to destroy them. Yes, destroy them. Now, as you can see, I just basically worked away at them, but after you use the element that opposes them once on them, you really can just do your standard, ghost capture. But sometimes it's just easier to keep blasting them away with whatever element you're using. So we're going to skip until the room is lit up. Alright, that should have been the last ghost, and here we go, the room is lit up, and you got yourself some nice monies. Now, I'm going to be looking for the boo, and because you're kind of at a disadvantage in this room, the boo can escape through the walls, as you might have noticed already, so you really want to try and capture this guy the first time. As you can see, I didn't, so I'm basically going to find him later. So, you know, going back through, getting all the monies. Now, you might realize that the yellow light is still on. And I believe that that is because there's still the dub, the fake object that the boos use to, you know, fool you. Not that it really fools anybody, but I'm checking the fixtures, and I open this up, and it's so beautiful that my face is just amazing. You got yourself a sapphire, you got yourself, I believe, an emerald, and I like to call it a ruby. It doesn't really look ruby. There's probably a different kind of name for it, but, you know, I'm not too familiar with my stones. Used to be, fourth grade, used to be, but not anymore. Okay, so now there are two ways to get out of the room. You can either scan that mirror right there, or you can re-scan the mouse hole that you came in from. All right, so let's get out of here. All right, back in the butler's room. Now, as you may have realized before, there were like candlesticks being carried by a ghost out in the hallway. What you want to do is you want to go up to those candlesticks and light them with the your newfound fire element. Let's skip to that. All right, here we are. Light the candles on fire, and this big sissy man here will be scared of the fire, but, you know, he's a ghost, so I suppose he's got a right to be scared of anything that gives off light. Now, this is going to be a pointless chase of him going this way, faking you out completely, and going the other way. And, of course, he's going back to the butler's room. Now, you know, keep up with him. It's really not that hard unless that guy comes out of the ceiling. All right, so you're going here. He comes through there. Now you're back in the butler's room. He's coming. I know he's coming. There he is. Now, you know, I never really understood this, but he sits down in his chair. Gets smaller. He sits down, and then he starts going crazy. Like, I don't know, maybe he's got some problems. So I'm sucking his face up. Not really sucking his face up. You know, maybe like his entire body. And he kind of like, well, he doesn't really have a full body. It's more like a wisp tail thing. Okay, anyways, point is I got him. All right, so here we go. Room's lit. I'm collecting the pearls. Now I'm looking for the boo in the room. There's one from before, so let's skip to the end of the booze. Okay, we got the booze, and now we got the key, and the key should bring you to the conservatory, which I suppose is an old-fangled, good old-fangled word, for a music room. So let's head over there. Okay, so this is the door to the conservatory. Now there are, yes, very nice, a good amount of instruments in here. Checking the fixtures. Now what you want to do in this room is you want to, you know, knock on all the instruments, excluding the piano, because that doesn't count. I have no idea what I'm doing, but you'll see that I get to hit the instruments. Okay, so I guess I'm going to start off with the xylophone. Get on with it, man! Okay, there. Hit the xylophone. Music starts playing. I believe that is the cello. I'm hitting that. I think I'm just standing around listening to it. I always enjoy doing that. Alright, I don't know. That's either the saxophone or something. I have no idea what that is. You got your harp over here. And then my least favorite, the, I don't know, the drum thingies. Okay. So, you got all the instruments activated. That took way too long. And now, you go over to the piano and you see this face right here. Okay, she's going to talk to you, say that that was very beautiful. And then she's going to play a song on the piano and ask you about it. I don't know, you can feel free to watch me, but you won't really be able to hear anything. So, we're just going to skip past that. So, after this ghost asks you if you want to do battle with her, the music sheets, you suck up the music sheets, and then you start sucking her up. Yes. Now, I kind of missed a few times on this one, so let's just skip the embarrassing moment. Oh, too late. Let's skip the further embarrassing moments then, shall we? I like how I spiced up that transition. Anyways, we got her. So we're going to get the boo and the key in that chest, which should take us to, here's a guess, a complete guess at this, I believe it is called the dining room. So let's head on over to that. Here we are. We'll see if it really is the dining room or not. Don't slip on the banana peels that are on the ground. Yes, dining room. All right, now, there is a blue ghost and a block of cheese in here. The blue ghost is in the cabinet right here. So suck that face. Okay, I'm going to stop saying suck that face. Just suck that guy up, okay? Just do it. Just do it. I don't care what it sounds like. Just do it. Oslo. I'm so sorry. Anyways. All right, so we got the money from the blue ghost. And the block of cheese, I believe, is located under the chair on where the... You'll see if you're watching. I mean, like, you know. All right, it's under this chair right there. See it? Now I'm repositioning myself, so I got the best possible chance. Scan the cheese and get this guy in the face. All right. So we got that guy, and it was so beautiful. All right. So you want to use the fire element on the candles that you see on the table. That way you'll be able to see this guy, even if you're looking at him. Okay, so what you want to do is you want to suck up the food that is on his plate. Then he'll get really angry, and he'll start having, like, a heart attack, and start spitting fire at you. Now, the only obstacle that is keeping you from getting all the food off his plate are these waiter ghosts here that bring more food to him, but, you know, they're easily dealt with. In fact, you don't really even have to defeat them, because you can probably just clear out all the food in, like, a few seconds. Okay, that guy was a big jerk running into me like that. Alright, so that should finish it. And now he's going to spit fire at you for 7 days. So, let's just skip past that part until he knocks himself out. Okay, so after the 7 days are done, he like falls down on the table, and then you can start getting him. You know, getting him. Once again, I'm not at my best here. So, where was I? Oh, yeah, I forgot that I got that guy in one shot. Nice. All right, you're really going to love the stuff that's in the chest in this room if you take after my amazingness. Okay, so I'm looking for the boo. So, once again. All right, got the boo. What am I doing? I don't know why I just did that. Okay. So we're going to go over to the chest, and we're going to get the beautiful amazingness that is inside. Are you ready for this?
I never get tired of that. It is so amazing.
All right, so we're going to pick up all the money. And, yeah.
Is he ever going to find him?
Of course he is.
Have you played it to the point where he finds him?
How many times? I told you. I've beaten this game more than that.
Okay, so how much longer until you find it?
You'll see.
That was my grandmother asking about where and how long it was going to take to find Mario. That's kind of why she... That's the only reason she sat there with me while I did this, was to see Mario at the end for like 5 seconds. Anyways, there you go. You saw your elemental ghost with the fire and blah, blah, blah. So now this is the important part where you get the next element. It kind of seems like a short increment. It's the water element. So let's head on over to that now, shall we? Alright, so we're knocking on the chest with the water medallion, and good times that we got it. Alright, so go figure, the water medallion lets you use the water element, which will help you put out the fire that is on the door that you need to get through to progress in the game. Also, it brings out a lot of monies. You'll see. So, once again, another one of those little ball guys. Get the water. And then you use it to put out the fire. Yay. Yes. Alright, so now we're going to go outside. After I pick up that heart. Alright, so we're going outside. And this is kind of like a little atrium area. And you see you got a little shell down there. We'll get to that later. So what you want to do here is you want to get the dog's attention by going up to him. And he's going to chase you. And if that happens, if you don't get away from him in time. So you want to attract his attention. If you had failed once, you want to attract his attention again. You want to get him to chase you a few times, you know, go after you. And then this guy calls himself Mr. Bones, comes out of the ground. Or I actually don't know where he comes from. So you want to suck him up. And once you get him, a bone flies out of him, and then the dog is distracted by the bone, which then gives you the advantage, or the chance to catch him. So now I'm working on the dog. I do believe that I had let him go once, which was not so cool. So let's get to the end of that now, shall we? Okay, so we got him. And now, real quick, go over to that thing on the ground there, and I want you to water. All right. After watering enough, a sprout grows out of it. Now, it's important to visit that thing after each completion of an area, including the completion of this area, because in the end, it really is worth it. Okay, so now I believe it's a cemetery graveyard. Go over to that pipe I was just at, bang on it, and you get the red ruby, not ruby thing. Now, you want to go over to one of these tombstones and hit one of them, because then it activates... a battle that it's not really a battle, but all these guys come out of the ground and you deal with them. So let's get to the end of me dealing with these guys. Okay, they are dealt with. Now, after getting all of them, the biggest tombstone there starts to light up. I want you to go up to it. Okay, well, I mean, like, you gotta go up to it. And then it's
boss battle time. Boom, boom.
All right, so this ugly guy here, I believe his name is Bogmire, the Graveyard Shadow. It's kind of unknown how he transports you to this place, but then again, it's a bit unknown how you get transported to the places during the boss battles anyway, so... Yeah, anyways. Here we go. Cutscene. Blah. Shadows. Alright, so I'm going to explain the main thing, what you want to do here during this battle that's going to help you succeed. Okay. So you see those shadow guys. You want to suck up the shadow guys, and they turn into this ball. You shoot the ball at Bogmire, and that's when you get to start working away at him. This to me was the hardest in the sense of actually keeping him, like, you know, hooked on to your stream there. I just couldn't do it. I just couldn't get this guy in one shot, even if I wanted to. I'm telling you, I could maybe after maybe like 1,000 tries, but I'm telling you, it's crazy hard. Because, I mean, like, he doesn't really float. He, like, moves around on the ground. So, let's get to the end of this boss battle where everything is nice and happy. Yes. Okay. Hopefully you didn't have too much trouble. He won't have too much trouble with that. Anyways, here we go. Big key for area 3. Very nice. Once again, Eged calls you, blah, blah, blah. I told you the compliments, something like that. And let's head back to the lab then. Okay, we're back at the lab doing the portraitificationizing. We're just gonna, you know, quickly skip through that. Alright, da-da-da-da-da, and that should be it for Area 2. Thanks for watching. Alright, see you next time.